The windshield wiper follow-through is probably one of the most common follow-through variations in the modern game of tennis. You see it used by Federer, Nadal, Djokovic, basically every single pro on the tour. And they use it to generate heavy topspin to control the rallies. So obviously the windshield wiper follow-through is key to building an elite modern-day forehand. Everybody wants to learn it. But the question is, how can you learn it and execute it into your game? What's up, athletes? You're here because you believe that you can maximize your potential on the tennis court with the law of success: learn, apply, and win. So let's get right into learning about this modern day forehand called the windshield wiper follow through. Let's go. The follow through of the modern day forehand is a lot different from the follow-through of the past, the traditional forehand of the open era. Today, you see an intense amount of spin on the ball brought about by the hand, arm, and racket rotation described as the windshield wiper forehand stroke. The way the racket follows through in the modern day forehand resembles the quick, rapid movement of the windshield wiper in a car, hence the reason why it's called the windshield wiper follow-through. Now, I must warn you, as simple as this sounds, there is nothing simple about the windshield wiper follow-through. In fact, it's one of the most complex biomechanical movements in all of sports. And while it's also one of the most misunderstood, it's no doubt a dynamic element in the modern day forehand. One reason for this complexity is because there are a lot of variations of the wiper. There's no set place to finish your racket or one stroke that you have to follow through in. The windshield wiper is a fluid, adaptive technique, and using more or less windshield wiper action allows you to add tremendous variation and spin to your forehand. One thing's for sure, the windshield wiper is here to stay, and once you master it, it's a winning shot. John Yundell defines the windshield wiper forehand as a unitary counterclockwise rotation of your hand, arm, and your racket in the forward swing. So the question is, what drives this hand, arm, and racket rotation to turn over to create this windshield wiper action? It's the power that comes from the rotation of your upper arm in your shoulder joint. So you're probably asking, how can such power come from your shoulder joint? Here's how. The internal rotation of your upper arm at your shoulder joint plays a critical role in your forehand stroke. And to understand that fully, take a good look at your shoulder. It's a fine piece of machinery. As a matter of fact, your shoulder has the greatest range of motion in any joint of your body. Your shoulder is made up of four joints. These are the glenohumeral joint, the AC joint, the CS joint, and the scapulothoracic joint. The glenohumeral joint is your main shoulder joint. This is where the ball of your upper arm fits into the shallow socket on your scapula. This shallow socket is called the glenoid. The second joint, the AC joint, connects your collarbone and a bony projection off your scapula. For the third joint, your arms and shoulders are connected to the main skeleton in the front of your chest through the CS joint. And the fourth joint, which is the scapulothoracic joint, is quite unique. It's located where your shoulder blade glides against your ribcage. It's a sliding joint that keeps your muscles that surround your shoulder blade. Now, one of the primary drivers of this internal shoulder rotation or windshield wiper action is your rotator cuff muscle. And there are four muscles that make up your rotator cuff. These muscles are the supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor, and subscapularis. The supraspinatus muscle contributes to the stability of your upper arm. The four muscles in your rotator cuff not only help you raise your arm from the side, they also help you rotate your shoulder in any direction. Another muscle that contributes massively to the power of the windshield wiper follow-through is your deltoid muscle. The deltoid is the largest muscle in your shoulder. So even with a brief overview of your shoulder's anatomy, we see that there's so much beneath the surface, both literally and figuratively. And it all controls your shoulder, and this is what allows your racket to rotate up to 180 degrees or more in your forward swing. Now, to explain what all of this means for you, I want you to answer this. Can you remember a time when you were first learning how to hit your topspin forehand stroke? Most likely, you were told and taught to brush the backside of the ball with your racket. For you to do that, you would have to vertically move your racket up because that creates the friction between the strings and the ball to create topspin. And sure, vertically moving your racket up to brush against the ball by raising your entire arm puts a certain amount of spin on the ball. But to really generate the topspin of advanced forehands, you need the immense rotation of your shoulder of the windshield wiper forehand action. Now, the first key to achieving this is to find the correct contact point, which I covered back in module 4. Now, without the proper contact, your shoulder will not have the strength needed to generate that vertical rotational racketed speed that you're looking for. So, once you've found your contact, focus on rolling the ball and rotating your racket over to create this windshield wiper action. The good thing about the wiper is that you'll be able to vary it in certain situations, and you can manipulate your hand and your arm to rotate more or less depending on the amount and kind of spin that you want to put on the ball. And as we'll cover more about in the extreme wiper variation video in the bonus section, the wiper can also help you hit some short, mean short angle shots. Now, one thing to note is that even if you have the classic or milder forehand grip variations, the windshield wiper action is still super relevant for your forehand. The classic grip gets your forearm to rotate at 90 degrees in your forward swing, while the extreme grip variations get your racket to rotate all the way through your swing up to 180 degrees or more. So needless to say, this element of your racket rotating over in the forward swing has always been part of the forehand. But with more rotation, with more extreme grips, the wiper takes a spotlight in the modern day forehand. So no matter what grip you're using, you can make the wiper a critical element in your forehand stroke. If you watch the greatest players, it seems like they can hit just about any shot from anywhere on the court. They exhibit limitless variations of the wiper. So before we really conclude that the wiper can generate that massive power in your forehand stroke, we need to understand three critical elements that affect the variations of the windshield wiper forehand. The first is how much your racket is turned over in the forward swing. With the windshield wiper follow through, you can actually rotate your racket at 180 degrees or less. Of course, this depends on the kind of grip you're using and what situation you're in. But the point is, the wiper allows you that extra movement that you can turn your racket over for more topspin. The second factor is speed. Depending on where the completion of your wiper rotation takes place, the stroke can be faster or slower. And third is how your hitting arm is prepared at the start of the wiper. For example, the hand, arm, and racket can be rotated backward and downward so that your racket tip points directly down toward the court. So by starting with your racket rotated outward in a lower position, you can increase the rotation of your hand, arm, and racket head by up to 50%. These three critical factors bring a wide range of limitless variation and power to the wiper when used in combination with a full extension position or with a lower, shorter finish and more wiper. You can generate powerful drives, deal with high balls, or even hit short angle balls. Here's the thing. The best time for you to incorporate more of the wiper element into your forehand stroke is when you already have a good grasp of the fundamentals of stance, preparation, and extension. We've covered a lot about the windshield wiper. We've covered why it's so great to master, how it's evolved since the open era, and the anatomy of your shoulder. So next, I want to cover the exact progression drills that I want you to take from this video onto the court so that you can start implementing this windshield wiper action into your matches. So start out by catching your racket as you follow through on your forehand. This will allow you to develop a basic feel for your forehand contact and finish. Once you've found some consistency with this over the shoulder or catching finish, you can gradually start implementing more and more rotation or windshield wiper action for more topspin on your basic forehand. I recommend that you start out hitting balls at around waist height, and then from there, you can start implementing this into different scenarios, like for low balls, wide balls, and high balls. Now for lower balls, you can gain more consistency by increasing this rotation or windshield wiper action for more topspin and to get the ball over the net and down into the court. But it's important to note that you're using your entire shoulder to bring about this extreme topspin and not just your forearm. Lastly, you can progress to practicing against balls above your shoulder. Now for these shots, you can drive through your shots more while still incorporating this full windshield wiper action for a flatter drive. So athletes, you've learned. Now comment below how you're gonna apply the instructions in this video so that you can win. And whether it's gear reviews, more footwork videos, more technique videos, I'd love to know what topics do you want us to cover next. And if you haven't already, be sure to click that subscribe button, hit that bell notification button while you're at it, and like the video if you like the video. And until next time, guys, go out and train hard. See you in the next video.